Man, Fleek be loving that la-la-la. Beanie Sneaker always loving that la-la-la. Neptune track smoke like la-la-la. It's the rock, baby, sing I love the vibe. Come on! Excuse me, miss. You should come hang with me, basically. Hold up, skip all the singing, let's get right tonight, mommy. I know my English ain't as modest as you like, but come, get some, you little bums. Take the cake from under the baker's thumb. I bake the cake, get two of them for one. Then I move the weight like I'm Oprah's son. I show you how to do this, son. Young, no mess with chicks and Burberry patterns. Fake Manolo boo straight from Steve Madden. He patterns himself to rap JFK. You wanna pass with my Jacqueline on asses? Then hop, yeah, top that S-class. Lay back in that Maybach roller best. I ask. Have you in your long-legged life ever seen a watch surrounded by this much pink ice? Look, but don't touch, young scrubber, think twice. Cause I got that, I clutch, got a little red light. Need a light, the light that la-la-la. Beanie Siegel always loving that la-la-la. Ben Fleek always loving that la-la-la. It's the rock, mommy sing, I love la-la. Come on!
Woo! Now cut for me, mommy, up! Just cut for me, mommy,
just blaze!
Me, mommy, up.
Ooh.
Now cut for me, mommy, up.
Ooh.
Now cut for me, mommy, up. Just cut for me, mommy,
just blaze.
Okay, yeah, free, okay. Yeah, Wale. Said tú quieres mujeres, she says she flow la la.
Flip side.
Now she my baby mama. Get wild. Okay.
Freeway got the hood on smash. Pop and take. Step on gas and get ghost. Freeway got the club on lock. Step on stage, set it down. Me with a bra, check for an edge. Post up, fans up, circle the block. Call the cops, it's the rock in your area. Post up, distribute to the block. Freeway, move the rocks in your area. Yeah, pop tried to shut me down. Cops tried to shut me down. Haters wanna hit me up, but my carry heavy rounds. Carry heavy rounds, packed in a Chevy truck. What? You better ring me along before I cock back. Dump on you and your boys. You have black shoes tucked on you and your mom. But back to the song, sis wanna s**t on me and the boys. I smell good in the thong. And she want me to sneak in a building like Trojan in Troy. Best believe it's Trojans involved. Head slipped over the boy, oh boy. We rip crowds, whole lot of volume and a little bit of bass. It's all it takes to make the place get wild. Whole lot of style and a little bit of cake. It's all it takes to make her skate flip side. Flip side. Flip bows and a little bit of bass. It's all it takes to make the block get wild. Get wild. Hot cheese and a little bit of cheese. It's all it takes to make her leave.
And you so fine, it's so sad. Still got a coach, need a coach bag. Let me coach you, no coach tags.
What that mean?
Get rid of that coach bag and listen. I ain't trying to throw jabs. Yo girl, get a notepad. You ain't got no swag, and you so fine, it's so sad. Still got a coach, need a coach bag. Let me coach you, no coach tags.
What that mean?
Get rid of that coach bag and listen, I ain't tryna throw jabs. Why you getting so mad? Only one that deal with Kim is a queen. Louis handbags, Alexander McQueen. He extended but mean, but how I handle my team. Clean, all them niggas don't wear sandals with jeans. Car scale gun, I can handle the beam. Nickel dime 20s, I can handle the fiend. So, hey,
I just get my broom and fly away. I'm going real, real far away.
Old school, got my Mac notebook with the Pro Tools. Got the thing ready for Nicki Lewinsky. Bad wolf, wolf, flyer than a frisbee. So I'm up in the way, eat the mangoes. Keep a couple pink toes in my sandals. Got some bangles all over my ankles. Such a star, they sing in a star spangle.
I am the rap henna. My mind, Montana, so fix your antenna. I keep three hoes, but don't call me Santa. And I'm flyer than reindeers in a winner, in a winner.
Mentality, cause I just came from another galaxy.
want to say is, it's our first, Raps First. The host, you call me House Money because I do believe at the end of the day, the house always wins.
House Money.
Now, I got some special guests also part of the show. I'm going to skip this man here first, though. I'm going to get to him last. To my far left and to your right, the odd professor, Mr. D.
That's me.
All right?
Philly's on.
And then we have my man Trouble. And when I say this, I mean this from the bottom of my heart, man. It couldn't have been no more realer. Trouble is this young man's name. Now, real quick, the show, we're going to showcase new rappers, underground rappers.
Old school rappers.
Get some, exactly, some old school in here. We're going to talk sports, clothing. We want to be Raps First on everything. Because right now, there's no other show out there I feel is going to do what we're about to do right now. So, behind the turntables.
What's going on, people?
My man, Global Vito.
How are y'all?
What's up, man?
I'm good.
Vito spending some joints over there.
Yo, give him a scratch real quick. Let him know it's all live, Vito. Don't hesitate, man. Let's make this rock, baby. Uh-huh.
We got to get that back in hip-hop. The DJ's on doing the hooks.
Scratch so real quick, hooks. Vito. If people want to hear you, they want to get your music, where can they go?
Well, you can go to thatsenough.com. I'm always on there. Global Invasions, I do a show.
Okay.
I do a show on there. Also, Free Agent Radio. You catch me every Friday at 6 p.m.
Okay.
I'm coming after my boy DJ Cam. It's out in Philly. It's called freeagentradio.com.
My man D, he's from Philly.
Yeah.
Man, he's party out there.
Sorry, okay.
he's good out there, man. So now, this is the type of show we're going to debate all topics. And I want to apologize early. Look at these boys about to heat it up. So now, our first discussion is how hip-hop has changed drastically in New York City.
Right.
Like, you hear more down south music than you hear of our own kind.
Because that's what's big out here now.
Right. So, I want to find out from these guys, is it radio part to blame for all of this?
Of course.
Now, I'm going to start with you, Trouble. Because it's important to me right now. I need to know. Because we talk about this all the time. So, do you feel that it's radio takes its part in all this, man?
I think radio plays an extreme part in this. Well, New York radio in particular. Because when you go to Cali, they don't play down south music like that all day long. You still hear West Coast music along with Southern rap integrated in the middle. But New York radio has seemed to change its way so that it's playing, you know, predominantly Southern hip-hop, you know.
So, D, you feel we're on the outside looking in right now?
Look, I'm going to say this. I think we got caught up in the guns, the glorifying of the drugs, and everybody else wanted to party. So that's where I think we got stuck at.
Okay.
Right?
So let me ask a question because, you know, I think radio needs to definitely change how they, you know, put out the music. When I look at the playlist on some of these stations, it's mostly, you know, down south music mm-hmm. that I see on there. Not enough New York. Now, I can't recall, but who was the first New York rapper Trouble to let a down south rapper on their song?
The first New York rapper to do that.
I mean, was it Jay-Z and Juvenile? Was that the first big collaboration?
That was a huge collaboration, I would mm-hmm. say. That was giant.
Dipset also.
Yeah, Dipset also.
With T.I.
But
now, real quick, was those guys already established, or did New York rappers help boost those guys up?
I think they were already, they were always established. When you went down south, their music was huge.
Okay.
You know, it just wasn't played up here.
Okay.
You know, so songs like that you heard on a constant down there. If you went to New Orleans, you heard that all day long, Juvie. It took a long time to reach here.
Okay.
But like you said, though, I think that the New York artists helped boost them over the top.
That's like, because I was a Juvenile fan, but I was a bigger fan when I heard him with Jay.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
You know, so my thing is that
that's only because you were from New York. Right. But if you lived down there, you were a Juvie fan.
Okay, so basically, it helped both. Jay and Juvie.
It went hand in hand. It went hand in hand.
But now it's out of hand. So now, what should some of the New York rappers do? What should some of New York rappers do then?
I think it comes down to making better music, getting better production, all of that. I think it all factors into the equation.
So then who you guys want to blame?
I mean, we got to be more consistent, you know?
I blame New York rappers. Let me tell you why. Putting out garbage material.
Garbage material?
Garbage material.
Okay, so who came out recently that disappointed you?
From New York?
Yeah.
We haven't come out. that's one part. But you can't say that you didn't come out, because like a dude like French Montana has come out, but he just has that down south feel to it.
So he's a New York artist, but he just happens to have that down south feel to it.
But
that's,
why?
That's what it
but
is.
Why? He's from New York.
You know
so
what
why?
It is? Because that's what's playing on the radio right now. That's what it is.
So he's about making
that's
the money.
It could be. I'm not going to say that's what it's totally about, but I feel like that's just what's popping right now, and I think that's what he's doing. That's the trend that he's following right now.
He shouldn't be following that format, though. You're from the premier hip-hop.
Because down south
city.
Don't follow us like that.
No.
Lil Wayne ain't trying to sound like New York.
But at the same
time. And we
time,
kill his music up here.
The game changes all the time, man. Different things happen, man. Things change. That's what it is.
Then how do you explain places like West Coast rap? It doesn't change. You will always, if Cube dropped a track today or tomorrow, Big Boy in the Morning is gonna play it.
He's gonna play it, but that doesn't mean the rest of the, you know, the rest of the U.S. is gonna follow suit. They had their run when Dre, Snoop, all of them, you know, they came out early 90s, mid early 90s, whatever.
But their artists are still going strong out there. It's just here you don't hear it.
Do you blame mixtapes for that, though?
Mixtapes.
Because, you know, every time, I can't remember when I've heard, at least recently, a New York rapper put out an album. Mm-hmm. I hear mixtapes, you know, like Ross will put out a bunch of mixtapes, but then he'll drop an album. But I don't see too many New York rappers doing that. I'll give an example. How do you guys feel about a rapper like Mano? He doesn't try to sound down south. We agree on that?
He doesn't. But at the same time...
So why he's not getting at least more love on the radio here?
It's not a high quality of hip-hop. It's not a Magna Carta. It's not, you know, it's not of that magnitude.
But Jay was getting played on the radio before it got to that Magna Carta status, though. That's what I'm saying.
But Jay is Jay, man. He a different breed.
That's a different day and age.
It's different
altogether.
Yeah.
Okay, so then a guy like Mano, now he has a name.
Right.
So you mean to tell me, so then what does that say to a new rapper coming out, though? Like, what would be your formula trouble to a guy that's coming out now?
From New York?
Yes.
He needs to go back to the essence. He needs to go find producers like Pete Rock, Premier, mm-hmm. You know, a lot of, you know, Ski, dudes who help Clark Kent, you know, producers who have helped build that New York sound.
Okay.
And put it on a certain plateau instead of going to down south. Now, there's an art to that, though. It's cheaper to go pay a guy out of Atlanta $3,000 than to pay these guys, you know, who do this type of production. So that plays a factor into it, too.
Okay.
So let me ask you this, though.
I mean,
is money factoring into it? Is that what it is? Is it money that's hindering New York hip hop?
Part
is that
of
what
it.
It is?
Part of it. Because you get when you get your budget, you know, you don't want to rip your whole budget paying, you know, a producer this amount of money when you can pay somebody from, you know, one of these kids to do it for $3,000.
Okay. Well, here's my thing. We can all agree on hip hop's missing some fire, right? Is it kind of, I mean, for, as New York is concerned, we don't have enough fire in hip hop. Is that right? Can we agree on that?
I agree.
Much of trouble. There's a reason why I'm saying this.
Nah, I don't agree with that.
You think there's fire?
I think there's still, I still think we have tier one artists. I just think they need to, remember when Band From TV came out?
Mm-hmm.
You know, the Nori track, which featured The Lox, Big Pun, Cameron.
Mm-hmm.
It's a classic song.
Right.
You know, New York artists got together, they jumped on one track. You couldn't even get all New York artists on one track. You couldn't get Jay Nas, 50, DMX on a track right now.
But then that goes back to what I'm saying. I think it's lost its fire. You know, like Big Sean puts out a record, Control, right? Kendrick makes some comments about other rappers.
Mm-hmm.
Now, did the right group or individuals respond in your take?
Yeah.
To Kendrick's remarks? Did the right ones respond, or was there a few missing off your list?
No, I do. I think the right people responded. I think the older class, or the golden age class, it's not their place to respond. It's up to the new age, new guys that's trying to come out and get their music heard. It's their job to respond right now. So I think the new people did, like Joell Ortiz, Fred the Godson. Those are the people that needed to step up and respond and say something, you know, like, what are we looking to Jay-Z for? He has a legacy already. What are we looking to Nas for? He has a legacy already. So it's up to these new guys to step forward to the forefront and, you know, speak their mind, you know? That's
all right,
my opinion.
So my thing, Trouble, is like a fad.
Mm-hmm.
Should Fab have said something?
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, these guys say
I agree
Fab
with,
had
I agree.
A record, King of New York.
But his legacy's not long like Jay. His legacy's not
so
long like Nas.
So therefore, he should have said something.
Exactly. I think so, in my opinion, yeah.
Who else should have said something then besides him?
I'm going to be honest with you. I think all of them should have said something because...
I agree.
In hip-hop, if you go back to the days of even Grandmaster Flash, Crash Crew, and those guys, it was about battling and who could be the best. Who rocked the party the best? You know, who do this the best? And right now, everybody's friends. We all can't be friends to be the best. Which I like Kendrick's point. The one part I don't like about what Kendrick did was, you know, he was on Big Sean's song, and you know, you're not gonna call me out on my own song. I'd have to do
it. I thought that was crazy. But Trouble was telling me about this, and he said that Big Sean had the best lyrics
on that song. Yeah. To me, he had the best.
So,
verse.
Do you think they talked about that before they went in the studio, or you think Big Sean was like, "No, he just didn't"? Like, you know what I'm saying?
Like what do you think? It's an element of surprise.
Yeah,
I think so.
I think Sean was shocked. I think he was shocked. I don't think that was staged.
Wow.
Because he even said it. He said, "You know, I had the opportunity to go back and change my verse, but I didn't."
Right.
No, but would that have been a deja vu with like a LL Cool J and Cannabis thing, because it could have turned into that. If Big Sean would have went back in the studio, do you think that Kendrick would have went at Sean like harder?
I would have changed mine.
You think he would have?
No, I said I would have changed mine. I'm sorry. I'd have went back in the studio.
Yeah, because that's an official album, right?
Yeah. No, it didn't make the album. The song never made the album. So they just leaked it out.
To get a buzz.
It made a statement.
Did it make a statement?
I think so.
Did, man. Yeah,
because now, during the BET Awards, watch out now. Didn't Kendrick go after Drake?
In the cypher.
Apparently so.
In the cypher?
I think so.
All right. I mean,
but yeah, you know, you want it, this kid, he wants to be the best. So in order to be the best, you have to crush your competition. There's no friends. You know, we can be friends after we get off the mic. But while we're on that mic spitting that hot 16,
right.
I'm against you. If we're on the same track.
But sometimes you have to be friends. You know, like, I understand why they put a 2 Chainz on the album. Because they want it played, you know, in certain parts of the country. They need their music played. So if you have one of those artists on there, then your song get played down there. So I understand why they're friends. I don't really understand why Kendrick made this particular move to talk about all the other rappers. Did he mention any West Coast rappers? I mean, I know he said King of New York, but is that all he's good for? Like, he ain't up in the West Coast.
He didn't mention any of his crew.
See, and I got a problem with that. Like, he just stuck with New York. Why you pick on New York, though?
But at the same time, who else on the West Coast is doing anything right now besides him? Like, Game kind of fell back for a minute. You know, he dropped something recently, but besides that, everybody from the West Coast kind of fell back for a minute.
It wasn't all New York rappers.
No?
No. Big Sean's from Detroit. Drake's from Toronto.
Okay.
Just two, really, were from New York.
But what I'm saying is, he said, I'm the king. Like, I don't know how you know, let me ask a question. If this was in the 90s, you got Biggie, you got Jay, and somebody says, I'm the king of New York, how do you think those two guys would have responded to that?
Biggie used to say it all the time. He used to call himself Frank White, the king of New York.
But let's say somebody outside said that. You know what I'm saying? You think Biggie would just say nothing and Jay would just stay quiet?
Nah. But you know what? You're talking about a different era, though, man. It's just like sports now. NBA, it's a different era. It's not the same. People don't have that same type of intensity.
But, you know, but hip-hop is always... But see, I disagree because to me, hip-hop, the music changed, but the foundation is far... Like disc records.
Mm-hmm.
Over time, there's still such thing as a disc record. No matter how far we're going to go, how far you go back, there's always disc records.
It's watered down, though. It's not the same.
Yeah, it's not the same.
It's not the same. Nah, it's watered down. It's not Cannabis and L. You make a song, I make a song, and it's over. It's I make a song, you make a song, I'll meet you outside with my crew.
Now, when somebody does make a disc record, is it to get a better name for themselves?
I think so.
So it's not even about he really dislikes somebody, it's just to get a better name?
I believe so. I think 50 led that march a little while ago, man.
So
he was trying to sell albums, man.
Trouble, real quick. When 50 went out, well, first of all, was you ever a Ja Rule fan?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so when...
I own a few Ja Rule.
So when 50 went at Ja, did it make you less of a fan?
It made me dislike 50.
Why? Why you say that?
Because I felt he was attacking him for something that he went and started doing. So, you know...
Did he do it as he was dissing Ja? Or was it after?
It was after.
But it doesn't matter.
After. He accused of, you're singing on the hooks, and the next thing you know, 50's singing on hooks. But their beef was personal. It was street. It was before music. It wasn't... That was personal. That wasn't really a music battle. That wasn't old school.
Right.
You know what I mean? That wasn't who could be the best rapper. That was personal.
Hmm. See, my whole thing with that with the whole diss records is that most of the time, you know, these rappers want to get a name for themselves, so they go after the biggest one in the market and figure, you know what, I'm gonna say something about him and get a response. But if that person doesn't respond to it, I think that would just kill the person who tried.
Absolutely. I mean, if you go back to even KRS battles with Shan, you know, that's the one thing KRS always says. The one way Shan could have killed me, not respond.
Wow.
But he immediately responded and KRS got the better of him.
The ego, man.
So, yo, D, what's your favorite diss record?
My favorite diss record? Not in Philly?
Anywhere, man. Anywhere.
I'll say Jay-Z Takeover. That's okay. Mel's.
I like that one.
I'll say that.
About you, Trouble?
Oh, as much as I'm a Hov fan, that's not mine. It would be Second Round Knockout by Cannabis. I think that's... He went after L with such aggression, you know, from talking about his kids to the awards he's won to the TV shows he was on. I mean, he dissected that man's career in two and a half minutes.
And I'm going to tell you, I'm a big LL Cool J fan.
I have no idea why.
And when that song, when I heard it on the radio, mm-hmm. you know, I was like, wow. I knew who he was talking about, but I said, nah, this can't be. And then I kept, you know, I'm listening to it. I'm like, nah, this guy's really going at L. But I didn't know the full picture right. at the time. Now, how did that? Why did that come about anyway? Trouble. Like, why did, Cannabis go at L that way?
Over the tattoo.
But before you start,
the mic with the crown.
But here's the problem though. He put this dude on his song, man.
Right. It was disrespectful on a couple of levels. You know, Cannabis had just came out. You didn't earn the right to wear that tattoo, you know. So, you know, he told him no. He felt some type of weight. He wrote the verse on 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
But, you know, I don't understand. If you're a guest, if I put you as a featured rapper on my song, I don't care what beef we had. You mean to tell me you're going to diss me on my own song? But you're going to come at me on my own song, man?
But I think it's just the art of competition. It don't matter what we're doing. If we're doing anything, I have to outshine you regardless.
You know what?
Of what
I'm helping you get your shine on. I'm giving you
Maybe that's what you're thinking in your head, but at the same time, at the end of the day, that's not what I'm thinking.
Okay, so let me ask another question. In the end of everything,
right?
Did it help Cannabis?
Nah. His album was trash.
And that's my point. But you know what?
It was.
If he didn't put it this way, if he didn't do what he did, he might have been on some other guest appearances.
I think the body of music speaks for itself. Like all of his mixtapes and everything leading up to that intrigued me to go buy the album. Now I was mad when I skipped school and went downtown to go get the album and came back and listened to it, and I was like, what'd I do all of this for? Because it was garbage. You know what I mean? So.
But he's a good underground rapper, right? Would you say? Right?
Who?
Cannabis.
What?
No? You don't think so?
No.
Yo, I'm going to tell you right now. This is Raps First. I'm going to tell you, more of this and a whole bunch of other stuff is about to go down. And we're going to be debating about everything. Vito, my man.
Yes.
Give us some music, man. Show us some love, man. Raps First.
Shorty, I got more money than I ever had. But you the only thing I need right now. And make it all so simple. You my new thing. I fuck her like an addict. She fuck me like she mad at me. But it's all cool though. I flew out to Nice just last week. When I'm away, she sent me pics in the sheets. So on my gin, on my cars and my sneaks. Wait. Let me keep this shit simple. The radio, this shit up in the tempo. Fat boy, blue jeans and a gold watch. Started at the bottom and she rolled on top. Black Testarossa, 0-60 on the strip, she's explosive. Just got back from Dubai. Emirates line flew in with 1.5. Never fold, it's the threshold. Like my mother saying, I'll never let go. Hood with an escrow. Bad, but she special. Went home and I prayed for an angel. Appeared in the dark, here to take away the pain too. War wounds on a big dog. But she get the ball like it's tip off. Watch D-Wade got 2 seats. Got everything but the blue beach. Cartier wings, 2 seats. You getting money like a new meat. We the knights of the Templar. Dirty little with 10 cars. This whole clique another Enron. Baby girl, it's time for you to get gone. There's a shoulder just to lean on. It's Rose, baby, and the team strong.
I got my eyes on you. You're everything that I see. I won't show high love and emotion. Endlessly, I can't get over you. Left your mark on me. I'll
pop Molly, I rock time four. I'll pop Molly, I rock time four. Clap for a nigga with his rapping nerves. Blow a stack for your endless with your trapping nerves. Clap for a nigga with his rapping nerves. Blow a stack for your endless with your trapping nerves. Time for. Time for. Time for. Coming up, coming down. Ride clean, fix your head in my crown.
y'all know y'all can fuck around. Paris, where we been, pop my Parisian. It's whole time, then no time, it's fuck all y'all season. Piss Bordeaux and Burgundies, flush out a Riesling. When hoes out, them hoes out, y'all put y'all weaves in and clap for a nigga with his rapping there. Blow a stack for your niggas with your trapping there. Spent all my euros on tuxes and weird clothes. I party with widows. Yeah, ho, yeah, ho.
Yeah. Raps first, baby. Once again, I'm your host, House Money.
Cowboy fan.
Because I feel the house always wins. Next to me, my man Trouble. Because that's what he is.
49ers fan. Did y'all even...
Ah, Professor Mr. D.
Eagles all day,
I like
baby.
That name for you, man.
Ah, hey, I appreciate it, man. Yeah,
my man me. From Philly.
Right. Yo, did y'all notice that the logo is 49er colors?
I did, man. I felt some sort of way at first, man. But sure. I accepted it, man.
Oh, hold up. We can't forget my man Global Vito on the 1 and 2s. So, Vito, man, every week, right? We good with that? Okay. Every week, you're going to hear this type of show throwdown. Am I forgetting anything, man? You got any shout-outs y'all want to make before we go? We get up out of here?
Well, we want to try and sneak in a once-in-a-while relationship-type question. No. Nah, not me, but I know.
I got a friend who kind of looks like me.
I'm gonna be careful with it, man. I know y'all laugh about me, but you know what? You gotta be the James Bond of this, man. Sorry.
Maybe I
watch too much TV. Ah, Professor Mr. D, man. So what, you good, D?
Good, man.
Every week, man, we're going to debate this.
That and a little bit of sports. I'm going to have some sports coming soon.
Yeah.
Sports coming soon.
This is just a taste of what's coming, man. We forget anything before we get up out of here?
Nah, shit, man. Let's do it again next week.
All right, you can also check us out on Classic Flavors of Band Rock, DJ Chubb Rock, WBLS, every Saturday, 6 to 9 p.m. My man Global Vito on the 1 and 2s. Vito's, take us out of here, man.
Triple beam up, this is fish scale. I bailed out the county with counterfeit bills.